إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الناس اتقوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة خلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام ان الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم اعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ان اصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى واحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد. In the seerah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, there is the story of Adi ibn Hatim al-Taie. Hatim al-Taie was the well-known generous man, but during the time of Jahiliyyah. Adie was his son. And the story of how Adie accepted Islam is an example and a story for anyone who is hesitant to think or hesitate by believing that the power is for this religion and that the victory is for this religion, regardless of who is against that religion. Adi ibn Hatim al-Taie was a leader on the tribe of al-Taie, and they lived in a place north what is known now Saudi Arabia, in a place which is known now as Taie. They lived in that area, north of Arabian Peninsula. And he was Christian. He accepted Christianity because he was very close toward Asham. And Asham at that time, they were Christian. And the news came to him that the Prophet was sending the expeditions to the tribes, informing them about Islam and that they need to accept Islam because the Arabian Peninsula, all of it, must have only one religion, which is Islam. So he said to his servant, the one who was taking care of his life starts as sheep to shepherd. When you go and take the sheep, listen to the other shepherds who are coming from the west side. What sort of news do they have? Usually when the shepherd, they let the sheep just go and eat and they sit and talk. So get from them, what sort of news do they have? Is there an expedition, an army coming from the west side? So Adi prepared two camels and he put on the camels all the food and drinks that he needs. The next day he asked his shepherd, is there any news? No, nothing. The third day, the fourth day, until a day he said to him, is there any news? So he said, the shepherd said to him, if there is a news or there is an army coming, what are you planning to do? So Adi said, I will take those camels and escape toward the Sham. So he said to him, do it now, because there is an army who is heading toward Taie. And he knew that this is the army of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He took his camels and he escaped toward the Sham. The expedition of the Prophet ﷺ reached Taie and there was no resistance. those who accepted Islam, and they came back to the Prophet ﷺ, but with no news about Adi, because the Prophet ﷺ, he wanted Adi to accept Islam, because he is a leader, and he is a son of a very generous man, all those high qualities this man had. So he wanted him, ﷺ, to accept Islam. So they told him, no, Adi escaped. The Prophet ﷺ said he will not stay long in Asham, and he will come back again. And I pray to Allah Azza wa Jal that he will come here and put his hand in my hand. The Prophet ﷺ knew that this is a leader. And when he goes to Asham, he is going to be a foreigner. He is well known to have his own settings, and so he cannot live long in Asham, and he will not live in Asham. And that's what happened. Adi could not stay longer in Asham, because even though he shared with them the same religion, but it's not his country, they are not his people, they don't speak the same language, they don't have the same tradition and custom. He is a generous man, he has his own setting where the people would come, and it's not there. So he decided to go back. But go back where? Now, the news came to him that don't accept Islam. Accept Islam, come to the Prophet. But he said, why? I have my own religion. He is sending expeditions for those mushrikeen. I'm not a mushrik. I believe in God. I'm a Christian. So it's not for me. But when he saw that everything was, all the doors closed against him, he decided to go to Al-Madinah. So he entered Al-Madinah, and the people saw him, and they knew that, you know, this is Ali, the son of Hatim Taie. This is a leader, the son of a leader, a well-known man among the Arabs. So everybody was looking at him, and he went directly toward the Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet ﷺ was sitting with his companions. He entered and he extended his hand to the Prophet ﷺ. And the Prophet ﷺ extended his hand and he shook his hand and he asked him, who are you? Of course the Prophet ﷺ knew who he is. He said, I am Adi ibn Hatim al-Taie. So he said to him, the one who is escaping from Allah and his messenger. So Adi did not answer. Now the Prophet ﷺ stood up and held his hand, the hands of Adi, and took him to his home. The Prophet ﷺ always put people according to their status. There is no distinction between them. All of them are the servant of Allah, but there are different status. So if a common man would come to the Prophet ﷺ, wanted to know about the religion, the Prophet ﷺ well asked one of the companions to take care of him. But this is a leader. The Prophet ﷺ will not tell him, sit, wait until we finish the lecture, and then I will go with you. The Prophet ﷺ wanted his Islam. One, because there is a great benefit of his Islam. The Prophet ﷺ walked to his home with Adi, holding his hand. You know, just think of the feeling of Adi, that the Prophet ﷺ is holding his hand. Three things happened during their way to the house of the Prophet ﷺ as they were walking. Adie was thinking, I am a leader of Taie, and he is the leader of a Medina. I have a religion which is Christianity, and the Prophet ﷺ has a religion which is Islam. I have a book which is the Bible, and he has the book which is the Quran. So, according to him, we are in a similar status. Then, on the way, an old woman stopped the Prophet ﷺ, and she said to him, I need to speak to you about an urgent matter. Old woman, stopping the Prophet ﷺ with the leader of Allah. The Prophet ﷺ could have said to her, can you do it later? Can I ask one of the companions, you know, go to so-and-so and talk to him and tell him that the Prophet ﷺ sent me to you? No. The Prophet ﷺ stood and he listened to the statement of that lady. And it was a long statement. And they did not stop in an office or something. They stopped in the middle of the road. And he listened to her until she finished. Not, you know, okay, just what is it that you need so we can finish up because I had a guest with me. No. The Prophet ﷺ listened to her until she completed her statement and finished. And she ended the conversation. Now Adi was watching this and he said, that is impossible to be the manners of a king. He is not a king. He is definitely a prophet. Then a man came and stopped the Prophet ﷺ and he was complaining about his situation, how poor he is. He has no food to feed his children. And the Prophet ﷺ gave him a few words to comfort him. And they continued, and a third man stopped the Prophet ﷺ and was complaining about that he lives outside the Medina and it's quite far, and when he comes there are people who stop him, those muggers, and steal from him. And the Prophet ﷺ comforted with few words, until they reached the home of the Prophet ﷺ. And in the house of the Prophet ﷺ, there was nothing in that house. Nothing. They used to sit on a pillow in Saba. They used to sit in the pillow. There was no chairs or no sofas or anything. So the Prophet ﷺ gave the pillow to Adi and he said to him, sit. Adi said, no. You, Prophet, you sit. He said, no, you are my guest. Sit on that pillow. He sat, and he said to him, Adi, why are you speaking from Allah and His Messenger? What is stopping you from saying, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah? So Adi wanted to answer, and he said, I have a religion, I am believing in Allah, I am a Christian. The Prophet ﷺ said to him, I know about your religion more than what you know about your religion. Adi was a Christian. But he was following a way in Christianity where only few people were following that way. The Prophet ﷺ said, aren't you Rakusi? Following the Rakusi yet? He said, yes. He said, when you attack others and you take from them what they have as bounties, you take forth of that. Isn't that correct? I said yes. Isn't that forbidden in your religion? Adi could not answer. He said to him, the Prophet, you took your leaders as gods. He said, no, Prophet of Allah. We did not worship them. The Prophet said to him, you did not worship them. But what was not permissible, they made it permissible and you followed them. And that's your way of worshiping them. Then the Prophet said to him, I know what is stopping you from accepting Islam. You think that we are poor. And you think that everyone is attacking us and we are weak. But, Adi, if you live long enough, you will see the Dhu'ina, the woman, traveling from Al-Hira, place in Iraq, all the way to Mecca, alone, to make the tawaf, fearing no one but Allah. And Adi was thinking, where are those mothers? Where are those people of Taie? They will not leave her alone. Then the Prophet said to him, if you live long enough, you will see the treasures of Kisra and the Hormuz spent for the sake of Allah. Now Adi could not comprehend that, and he said, Kisra ibn Hormuz, the same guy? The Prophet said, yes, Kisra. He was the leader of the Persian. They owned Iran, Iraq, Afghanistan, Pakistan. They had the biggest army. Ago, there are people complaining about how poor they are, how weak they are, and you're talking about Kisra. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him, you think that we are poor, but if you live long enough, you will see the person who would carry his zakat looking for someone to take it from him. And he will not find any, because all of them are rich and wealthy. And the Prophet ﷺ said, and there will come a day. Now that statement was for Adi and for everyone. And he said, the Prophet said to him, if there will be a day, there will come a day, where everyone will meet his Lord, and no one would translate between him and his Lord. There will be no translator, face to face. And he will look to his right hand side and he will see nothing but hellfire. And he will look to his left hand side and he will see nothing but hellfire. If you can fear Allah and do the good deeds, even with a half of the dates, do it. Adi lived long enough. He said, I lived long enough. And I saw the woman traveling from Al-Hira to Mecca to make tawaf alone. And I was among the army who conquered and defeated Kisra and took all the treasures and was spending, so it was spent for the sake of Allah. He died years after that, when Umar ibn Abdul Aziz became the leader of the Muslims. At this time, people were taking their zakat. And no one is accepting that zakat from them. The victory is for this religion. No matter what we hear in the news, or we see what's happening in the world, this religion will be victorious because it is not us who are taking care of this religion. It is Allah who is taking care of this religion. And we will see the victory of this religion if Allah Azza wa Jalla extended in our life. May Allah guide us to the best of all in our stuff for Allah in the last of the in our world.
والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب.
قريب مجيب للدعوات. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة.